Hello, it's me, Elder Schofield. I haven't done this in a while. Just sat down and immediately just started vlogging away. But yeah, hello, how are you? Happy New Year. It is a new year. Indeed it is. How are you doing? I'm doing absolutely fantastic. And this week was wildly chaotic. But I have... I almost said two in Cambodia. I'm just so used to Cambodia. I have two stories for you. Listener, I don't know. You are. How are you? I already asked you. But I have two stories about Cambodia, which are just absolutely fantastic and bring me so much joy into my life. Well, the first one was on New Year's Eve. We were invited to a member's house for a party. And parties here in Cambodia, well, like, you can have literally three people and it's a party. Because they will get the fattest speaker you have probably ever seen that they use at concerts. And then they just will karaoke the night away. Which, by the way, made me figure out, holy crap, in the songs that are, like, popular here, they are not professional singers. They are just random people just going at it. Going at it on the mic. I heard, like, three freaking six-year-old women all go at it. Sounded the exact same. No idea how that happened. But that's just fantastic. But anyways, we're just at this party, and so they just have this fat speaker, and someone has aux on it, and I'm like, oh yes. So I immediately go there and do what any sensible man would do in the first place, and I immediately just started playing Big Time Rush. It was just absolutely awesome because I just throw on Nothing Even Matters. Best part is the freaking Khmer's were all over that. I was like, oh yes. The adults at the party were absolutely loving my taste in music. Because the person who was on the aux beforehand was a 7-year-old child, so you know what garbage they're about to be thrown on the regular. The kid was just throwing up Remix 2021 and then throwing on stuff, and I was like, okay, I'm gonna go take control of this. And I immediately just throw on Nothing Even Matters by Big Time Rush, and I just dance the night away. But yeah, no, like, the Khmer's were actually all over it. It was so funny. Because I just was like, I just kind of threw in a joke, and also because I was like, frick, Big Time Rush is unreal. And like, they're just loving it. And then like later, I threw it on as well for the, I don't know why, I just threw on Nothing Even Matters again for fun. And then like, yeah, because like all the Khmer missionaries were just like absolutely grooving to it. I was like, oh my gosh, this is unreal. This is my people. They love Big Time Rush. Like, that's awesome. So yeah, that's that story. I just played Big Time Rush and I just gobbled up every single moment of that. I was all over that. But the second story I would not say is as pleasant. So if you're just like, don't want to hear just like something just so bizarre, I don't know, just keep watching or something, I don't know. I can't control what you do. But so this week, my companion, Elder McAlecky, he is his own leader. So he had to do exchanges in Battambang, which is 170-ish something kilometers away. So he was gone for a few days to do exchanges with the district leaders there. And so I was here on an exchange with... It is late. I don't know why I'm doing this. But with exchanges with elders that are currently serving in Siem Reap. And so I'm doing an exchange with them. I'm doing an exchange with one, and... when you teach one of his investigators, and he goes, hey, on the way back, he's like, hey... this family's out. If this family's out, then we're going to talk to them. If they're not, we're just going to go home. And so I was like, okay. And it's because he contacted this family. When this missionary freaking contacts this man, it's contacting the same family for a solid 45 to 50 minutes. I don't know how the man does it. But it's just like, I don't know. One time I was on a different exchange with the guy. And one time we were talking to this one lady for frick, like an hour and a half. Then at the end, he was just like, yeah, I just kept going in circles. And because that's what I was kind of noticing. I was kind of just like, then why did we stay there for an hour and a half? It was just going in circles. And she didn't even take our pamphlet. I was bamboozled, bro. But anyways, so we're talking to these people. Turns out they're all members. That's why they were talking to him in the first place before. But they're all members. That's cool. So I was like, okay, we'll talk to these people. But I was a little hesitant at first because in front of like their house is just this guy with one leg. So it already makes him sketch. But I'm joking, I swear. But I was just kind of confused. So he's just chilling, just one leg, no shirt on, as one does. And he's just like a little, I want to say he was unnerving. Like I was kind of like, I felt like really uncomfortable around him. But I was like, but sometimes people are just weird. So I was like, I feel a little uncomfortable. Then I later felt unsafe, but I felt uncomfortable at first. And so we're sitting down, we're talking to these people, and I'm like, This is the same day I crashed my bike, so frick, my leg was in so much pain. It was just like so sore and just dying. So, because I'm sitting crisscross applesauce, so I'm just freaking, just like, just slowly passing away in my seat. And I freaking can't even think right now. So we're just sitting there, they're talking, and because they're all members, then all of a sudden they start bringing out, like, I don't know, I wouldn't call it deep doctrine crap, but they're just like, where really is heaven? And we're just like, well, I don't know, dude. If I had the freaking address to heaven, do you think I wouldn't have gone there already? Gosh. But I don't know. But so we're just sitting there, we're just saying that. Then all of a sudden the guy with the one leg, he's been saying like random crap and he just seems a little crazy. But then randomly he grabs my shoulder and he like starts bringing me in. But I like immediately shrugged it off. Like, I am not coming near this man. But then he grabs it again, and he grabs it pretty tight. I was like, oh. So he pulls me all the way in. He pulls me in, and he goes up, and he goes right into my ear, and he's kissing the ear. He's just absolutely macking on that thing. I was like, oh, interesting. But so he's just going to town on my ear. But no, he's just right up against it. And then he whispers into my ear in Cambodian, "Stan soa jiamoy arek srul jing," and which that means translated, "Heaven with the devil is easier." What the frick does that mean? What does that mean? And so I just look at him and I just like slowly back off, and I was like, okay, I now feel unsafe because I'm 6'9". The man has one leg. If it came down to a fist fight, I would probably win, but I was crippled at the time, so I was like, oh, frick. This guy could probably outrun me right now. So that was not good. And so I'm just sitting there, Elder Hager's just absolutely going to town, contacting. Oh, not contacting, he's just teaching a lesson, like we were supposed to be doing. But I was just like, okay then. I'm just trying to have a time of my life and just not die, not get just absolutely molested by a possessed man. But anyways, then we're just talking. Turns out they're just talking, and then all of a sudden we just started like, they were probably like 4 or 5 times in the middle of the lesson, because like the guy who had the one leg just kept asking about it, but it was just like, and he was asking about this, so we're giving like example stuff. Every time we were in one of those prayers, one of my eyes was wide open, staring right at that man. I was like, I do not trust this guy with my eyes closed. But then one time we're saying the closing prayer at this lesson, and he's like going to go eat. Also, this is weird. So in Cambodia, in Khmer, there's different levels of forms of respect for words. So if I'm saying, if an animal is eating food, then they are seeing it. They see, nyam, hope, frick, I cannot, bisak, cannot remember the one for monks, and then there's like sawi, which is for kings. But bisak is for like 6-year-olds. Hope is for like people, I would say people just like 10 years older than me. And then yam is for like everyone around me. Then C is for animals or for very small babies, because that's just the culture. And so what he is saying, every time he refers to himself going to eat food, he's saying he's going to see it. And I'm like, I've never seen anyone ever do that. So I was a little confused and a little concerned. But so he's like trying to get rice, and they're like, okay, you can go get some rice. So he comes back with this rice, and this bowl of rice, and it's like watery. Like, it has a lot of water in it, and I wasn't ready for that, because I was like, that is just a little nasty. But So we're in the middle of the prayer, and this man is just absolutely just slurping up this ricey water. And also, I'm just like sitting there, like one eye open, watching this man, just like, and all of a sudden he's like, oh, I was like, frig. Like, I was like, holy crap, this guy is crazy. But then we're chilling, just sitting there. And then Alder Hager starts contacting the guy because the people asked us to, because they're like, you can just help this guy learn about God, because apparently this guy just invites the devil. I don't know. So we're talking to him about it, but he's just so crazy and like actually so off the walls high at the moment. He's not really getting it, but then he just like asks us for our name so we can write him down, frick, because my full name is Alder Schofield. But I have everyone, but if like most people call me Alder Sko because it's way easier to remember. And so I just immediately call him, I'd say because I usually introduce my full name first before I say Alder Sko. No, just Alder Sko. I'm not letting this man anywhere near my full name. And I tell him it in Khmer so you can never find me on the internet. And then this guy is talking about how he writes in demon script. I don't know. That's what they're telling, but I see this man just go into absolute town writing our names. And the way he wrote Elder for both our names was way different. This man was just high out of his freaking mind. There's no way. He was just freaking high, man. And he was just writing stuff, making comments about Satan. You know how it goes. We just love that. And I was the only time I've ever felt genuinely unsafe in a lesson was that. And so I've never left the house so fast. Like, the instant we said amen, I was like, oh, thank you, we gotta go, it is too late for us to be out, Jorablia, goodbye. I got on my bike and I started going. I was like, I am not staying there. Holy crap, this is 12 minutes. I do not have enough space on anything I have for a 12 minute long video. Frick, bye.
Man, it actually is good. I don't know why it's good though.
Yeah, frick, that is good. It's like one of the mini fishers.
Mm-hmm.
Man, Hunter, what are you doing?
We don't have a fetching key to the church. What do you think I'm doing?
I've literally never been more proud of anything I've done in Cambodia than getting these Cambodia kids to play Big Time Rush. I don't know why, but we ate this thing. It was just like hot dogs in the soup. And all my voice is gone. Honestly, all-time scenario. I sound so handsome.
Those are bats.
Just